that record, the Lucinda Williams record back then, I'm amazed at how many of the songs on that record were covered by other people. It says something about your songwriting. It says something about the power of those songs that so many other people gravitated to them. And of course, the famous ones, Mary Chapin Carpenter, Tom Petty, Emmylou Harris covering the songs that they did. But really, just about every single song on that record has been covered.
Yeah,
in some cases, more than once. How do you feel about that? When you hear other people, when you hear Mary Chapin Carpenter or Tom Petty sing your songs, do they still feel recognizable to you?
Yeah.
Do you feel some ownership creatively of their versions?
That's the biggest honor.
It's
really
an honor.
Yeah, as a songwriter to have somebody else cover your songs. Because for me, I know when I cover somebody else's song, I've got to be able to get inside the song and really connect with it and, you know.
You've done your share of covers, of course, yourself. Do you ever hear their versions and think, well, I wouldn't have done it that way? I mean, do you feel like you have the right to have an opinion about how they do it?
No. Yeah. Once I write a song and put it out there, anybody will say this is a songwriter. You know, it's just kind of...
It's theirs.
Anybody can do whatever they want to with it.
Right. I mean, and the Mary Chapin Carpenter cover of Passionate Kisses, which was such an enormous hit, won a Grammy for the songwriting... That was actually a song that was done as a country song, and I have read you say a couple times it wasn't a country song when I wrote it.
Right. I didn't intend for it to be a country song.
Right.
But the story behind that is that Mary Chapin and Roseanne Cash and I went on tour in Australia and New Zealand and did a Riders in the Round thing.
Yeah.
And on the way there, that's when Chapin asked me, when we got out there, she said, I really want to record your song, Passionate Kisses.
Yeah.
And, you know, can I have your blessing? And I said, of course. And so then when it was getting ready to come out, she wanted to be the first single, and her label said, no, we don't think that's a good idea. And she said, why? And they said, well, because it's not country enough, you know.
What a world this is.
Y'all,
no, it never
really
ends. It doesn't.
And so, and Chapin, you know, much to her credit, stood her ground and said, I don't care what it is. I want it to come out as a first single because my fans love it. And she'd been playing it live at her shows. And so, and, you know, she had a lot of pull back then. So they said, well, okay.
And boy, was she right.
And then it won, ended up coming out and winning a Grammy for Country Song of the Year.
Kind of amazing. A song that wasn't country.
Andrew,
that's great. How amazing.